What is up, dudes, and welcome back to the Chaos Theory Collection event patch notes. We're just gonna read through these, and it says here, welcome test subjects. The Chaos Theory Collection event kicks off March 9th, which is tomorrow, by the time that I'm filming this, and runs until March the 23rd of 2021. When it comes to the Caustic Town takeover, it says here that when life gives you lemons, you can count on Caustic to turn it into toxic lemonade. Breathe it in at the all-new Caustic Treatment, a new dominant mousetrap with lots of high-quality loot that beckons all legends who seek the glorious cheese. And here we have the complete rework, which is super beautiful and super exciting. Where the water treatment once stood, the new Caustic Treatment was constructed to prevent the crash site fuel spill from reaching the ocean. Or was it? Forever the scientist, Caustic has set out an experiment that requires test subjects to drain the toxic liquid from the center of the facility. Doing this temporarily grants access to 4 gold loot items locked in cages. Players must be quick though, as greed can be deadly. If you happen to notice that the Mirage Voyage is missing, you can put the blame on Caustic. The polluted fumes from Caustic Treatment really killed the vibe, so Mirage sets sail to take the party elsewhere. No one spotted it yet, but that party boat tends to show up in an arena when you least expect it. So, the Mirage Voyage is going to be flying away, but we're gonna read up more about that later on down the videos. Then we have the Ring Fury Escalation Takeover Heat Shields in the Survival Slot. Ring Fury is a new Epic's playlist takeover that follows regular BR rules, but each round one or more ring flares will appear on the map within the current ring. Ring flares are slowly expanding pockets of the ring within the arena. Maggie sure does know how to start a party. So, those who get caught in a ring flare will take damage equal to the damage dealt by the current round's ring. You'll be given a short warning on the map and minimap before the ring flare appears. Legends will call out if they are in direct danger or if there is one opening up nearby. How do you deal with ring flares? Well, two ways. First, try not to get caught in them, silly. And failing that, you can drop a new item we're introducing called heat shields. And this is something that I'm super excited about. Throw down your heat shield to avoid damage from ring flares or from the ring itself. And remember that you can always find more. The loot pool for this event has been turned into spread heat shields out throughout the map. And this is basically something that we're gonna start off with in our inventories. So this is how it's gonna look like, the survival slot. You'll notice that the heat shield doesn't take up any of your normal inventory slots, and instead it resides in the brand new survival slot. The survival slot tends to eliminate the choices between normal loot and situational utilities like a mobile respawn beacon or a heat shield. Now, there's no reason not to carry one of these around. Coordinate with your team, and the possibility for more survivability tactics soars. So this is a super exciting introduction of a new item that's going to be very helpful, and it's going to really make the game that more interesting, in my opinion. Introducing escalation takeovers. Like previous playlist takeovers, Ring Fury will replace regular duos and trios playlist for the 2-week duration of the collection event. Ranked will not be affected as always. It never gets affected by any of these takeovers. So don't worry about that if you're into ranked more than you are into the casual plays. So, however, unlike previous takeovers, Ring Fury is an escalation takeover, which means that every few days during the event, we're going to turn some knobs to crank up the prevalence, timing, and size of ring flares. And by the end of the event, you can expect 5 different stages of escalation. Exciting! And something that is very new, something that I actually talked with my boyfriend about, a new feature is going to be coming, which is called the no-fill matchmaking. And basically, the TLDR version is no-fill matchmaking is a new way to play the game as a solo legend, so solo queuing, here we come. And here is how it works and why you might choose to use it. This is how it's gonna look like. You're gonna get your usual trios and the usual ready button. But on the top of it, you're going to have a fill teammates checkbox. So, in the lobby, you'll now see a checkbox entitled fill matchmaking. This means that the matchmaking system will attempt to fill your squad with 2 duos or trios, whichever you queued for. This is how the game has worked up to this point, and will be the default setting after every match you play. So you don't have to worry about whether this is checked or unchecked, it's gonna be checked by default. So, by default you're still playing the normal version of the game, which is it automatically fills up the team. Whether it is duos or trios, doesn't matter. But they say, of course, we still strongly believe that at its best, Apex Legends is a game about team play. But we're launching this no-fail matchmaking as an option for solo players because we think it gives a lot of creative opportunities for you to play the game your way. And this is basically what I really was excited for, just because you can focus on completing certain daily and weekly challenges for the Battle Pass. You can warm up, drop hot, and get into lots of fights. Challenge yourself, can you win a round of duos alone, or how about trios? You can experience the latest lore teaser on your own. And finally, but not least of all of these, explore the map and experiment with characters you haven't tried before. Take an opportunity to learn a bit more about the game at your own pace, which is perfect for new players, I believe. But also for more experienced players who really want to not be dependent on other players whenever you're playing casual, because that is like the downside of team games. You really are very dependent on other people that you play with. But that is also sometimes a good thing, so nothing bad to say about this so far. I am super excited about the solo queuing, the no-fill matchmaking. Definitely something that I'm going to be trying out. So we have some limitations in place for no-fill matchmaking because we don't want it to greatly disrupt the experience of pacing with the game for other players. We only allow 6 potential no-fill players in any match, and the feature isn't available in ranked. Give it a shot and let us know what you think. We'll definitely be doing that. So, the Chaos Theory Collection event and rewards track. It ain't a collection event without new unlockables, and let's start with the freebies. As usual, the Chaos Theory Collection event brings a reward track with all new earnable cosmetics, this time including legendary Kraber and EVA 8 weapon skins. Oh my god. I am personally very excited about the Kraber and the EVA 8 weapon skins, just because I really love skins. I'm very into cosmetics in this game, which usually I am not when it comes to other games, but Apex just is so unique, and Respawn Entertainment and EA just make the best skins ever. So it says here, you can earn 1000 points per day in challenges refreshed daily. These are also straight challenges that reward 4 unique badges if you complete them during the event. All of these challenges also stack with your battle pass, so you can complete multiples at once. And of course, Chaos Theory also introduces a brand new set of 24 themed event limited cosmetics. Inspired by the Warriors of the Frontier, our legends are donning fierce new looks as they drop onto the arena. And here we have a little gif of the new skins. This is Revenant, Gibraltar, and who is this? I think this is Bangalore, and Pathfinder, of course. We have new Mastiff skin, and honestly, these are just so beautiful. I could not be happier about this whole change. And all 24 items will be available to direct purchase for Apex coins or crafting materials and in event packs for the entire duration of the event. If you collect all 24 event items, you will unlock the Bangalore Heirloom set. And this is something that I'm super excited about. I don't usually play with Bangalore, but this is definitely making me like want to play with her more. Bangalore took this pilot's knife off a cold-blooded opponent. Since that day, she has made it her own. We have a little gif of it here. Let's just wash through that. Such smooth movements, and the skin is so beautiful, honestly. I really am liking this Bangalore heirloom. And after the event ends, the Bangalore heirloom will become available via heirloom crafting. A few more nitty-gritty details on how the collection event will work. First, the crafting costs for the skins are returning to their regular pricing now that the anniversary collection event has ended. Second, each event pack will come with 1 event item and 2 non-event items at the following drop rates. And you can see the drop rates over here. We have for 1 event item, 50% event epic and 50% event legendary, then we have 70% rare, 20% epic and 10% legendary. And now for the legend update, something that I'm very excited about, super stoked. First we have the caustic. Nox gas grenade cooldown increase from 2.5 minutes to 3.5 minutes, so it has a 1 minute increase. And the Nox gas damages at a flat rate of 5 HP per tick instead of ramping up from 6 HP to 12 HP. And we have a little dev note here, caustic is brutally effective at slowing down engagements and enemies. The entirety of his kit revolves around gas with a large area of effect, slow vision obstruction and direct hell damage. It's proven to be too oppressive in too many scenarios, especially considering teammates can play in gas relatively impaired. Significantly reduces gas damage without taking it completely or having it affect armor instead. Seems like a fair compromise that stayed true to the character while making him less oppressive on the receiving end. We'll be monitoring the data and gameplay closely. If these changes hit Caustic's appeal for or effectiveness too hard, we will revisit accordingly, which of course Respawn and EA have always been like very good at making very quick changes that reflect what players like, what players dislike. So next we have Pathfinder, and they removed the low profile. Role profile has been used as a balancing tool for both mobile and or small legends. Although Pat is still mobile, his hitbox is large. While his overall win rate and encounter win rate is by no means low, it's hard to justify keeping low profile on a hitbox of his size, which I think is completely understandable, and I'm not unhappy with this change at all. And when it comes to Gibraltar, they removed the 15% faster heal item usage while in Dome of Protection. For Horizon, they increased the Black Hole cooldown from 2 minutes to 3 minutes, which I think it's pretty fair considering like how quickly 2 minutes passes by. But I think it's still gonna be a very, very like a fair change. I'm not unhappy with this. So for Revenant, Revenant's Silence now disables Mirage's Cloaked Revive and Respawn, as well as Octane's Swiftment. I think that's a very good change. For Watson, she has now passive shield regen at 0.5 HP per second, which is half of Octane's current health regenerate, and this is something that I'm super excited about considering that I really want to start playing with Watson more, or just start playing with her in general, because like I'm still a noob, I've only been playing for like a couple of months, but I'm really excited about this change. It sounds like a very, very nice change to have in the game. For Rampart, explosive damage to cover normally instead of inflicting 200 damage, and the explosive damage Sheila normally instead of inflicting 175 damage. And the devs left a note here for us. Walls should be beefy and powerful once built. Before Rampart shift, we were worried that her nest would be too oppressive, and so we gave enemy players the option to quickly clear them out with grenades. This was not necessary as it turns out, so we're removing increased damage from grenades against amped cover and against Sheila as well. Some little weapons updates. First of all, the weapons optics. All gold, AR and LMG default optics updated to 2x bruiser. For the Mastiff, pellet damage increased. Pellet damage decreased from 13 to 11. And the firing rate is increased from 1 to 1.21, which I am very happy with considering I'm a huge huge into Mastiff plays and flicks and whatever. Just left us a little note here. The goal of these changes are to place this weapon identity between the fast fire Eva 8 and the heavy hitting Peacekeeper. The Mastiff has consistently been dominant in close quarters combat given its forgiving spread pattern and high damage spikes with each shot. This change reduces the high damage potential in order to limit the amount of two pumps players experience on the receiving end. I think this is a pretty good change to the Mastiff. I welcome this change. And when it comes to the Wingman, plus one bullet to every magazine size, including base. The Hemlock also has an increased hipfire spread, and the devs left us a little note here saying the burst damage from the Hemlock's hipfire was feeling a little too consistent for an AR that should excel at medium range. This change mitigates the Hemlock's close quarters damage spikes that felt bad on the receiving end. Okay, so we have quality of life changes. King's Canyon loot. We've done a pass on the loot to bring up the quality across the map, while also maintaining a certain amount of loot after Mirage Voyage has flown away. And there we go, Mirage Voyage is gonna be flying away, dudes. So you gotta be quick if you wanna get to that. The wooden shacks across the map should have a few more pieces each, and generally be a little higher quality. Spotted Lake has been reduced to medium quality from high. Oh, that's something that you have to keep in mind. If you're used to going to Spotted Lake for your high tier loot, you have to keep in mind that it's gonna be medium quality from now on. The crash site has redistributed the loot in the area slightly, and the amount stays the same, but the higher quality loot should be in the ship. Caustic treatments have more loot than the water treatment, and it remains high quality. Locked weapon optic swapping. For guns with fully locked attachment slots, like fully kitted gold weapons and most crate weapons, you can now remove the optic and replace it with a different sight. This does not apply to the Kraper sniper rifle, of course. Assists have been added to the in-game HUD next to kills. This was already present in ranked and now has been added to unranked as well. So basically, if you're playing casual, you're gonna see your assists as well as your kills and your damage. And assists do not contribute to XP, this has replaced the spectator eye icon. Assists and knocks have been added to your squad's banners and will show at the end of a match. Okay, the club names now appear on match summary and champion screen if all players are part of the same club. Items will no longer stick to crafting replicator when dropped on the replicator. Yeah, that was a that was a funny little thing that happened. It wasn't game breaking, not for me at least. So the badge progress. For badges that have longer amounts of progress, covering over the badge will show you more information. For example, if you're trying to get 50 wins as lifeline, you will now see that you have 45 instead of somewhere between 15 and 50. That is very good. I really like this badge progress update. Just because if you're into badges like I am, I really love badges and just showing off what I've done. Just because I'm proud of my small little achievements. This is like really helpful. Ping my death box. While respawning on a dropship, you can now ping your own death box to help locate it easier. We have a little gif here that shows that the players being revived by a gold backpack will have a crackle of energy based on the tier of armor they wear while their revive is taking place. They will also display the armor heal effects when the revive is finished. This change should help players prioritize pushing a revive in progress. Okay, that is very good, I think. Players on PC can now go back to the title screen from the lobby to allow switching of data centers without restarting the game. Added number to the advanced look control. This should help people experiment and easily revert back to their favorite settings. When scanning a beacon for Ring 6, you should now be able to see the location where Ring 6 finishes. Inspect the weapons. Since the survival slot took its button on controller, we only have so many buttons. Inspect weapons has been removed to the emote wheel by default. It can be bound to any key on PC. And a little bit of like bug fixes here. Gibraltar corrected an issue when Gibraltar was not getting hit registrations when simultaneously releasing ADS and shooting while his gun shield was up. Wraith players can no longer cancel into the void by jumping at a wall. The new skydive emote will now work with legendary skins. Fixed a bug that was causing Nox gas to flicker for some players affected by it. Octane, repeatedly using the same jump pad no longer disables double jumps. Players are no longer allowed to glide along a wall after using a jump pad. Crypto. Crypto's animations to bring out his drone is no longer skippable by throwing a holo spray. Crypto can no longer teleport to a replicator, and reloading the Mastiff and 3030 will no longer be faster while in Crypto's drone. So when it comes to Loba, they fixed a few areas Loba could teleport into that would get her like really stuck, and like it was sort of a game-breaking bug as far as I know. And Rampart. Players can no longer use Sheila to get under the world when placed too close to the Phase Runner in Olympus. Fix the gravity lift for Horizon falling through the floor when used on the train tracks in World's Edge Sorting Factory. And using a zipline after a gravity lift will no longer increase accuracy. Oh my god. I did not know about that, dude. So, when it comes to our Fusey boy, Motherlode will now damage and destroy jump pads. When under a small enclosure, players will no longer be pushed out after using Motherlode. And the last one is players can no longer double the grenades after looting a dead Fuse's death box. For the Mastiff, dropping and picking up the Mastiff will no longer cause it to be reloaded. And the 3030 repeater, dropping and picking up the 3030 will no longer cause it to be reloaded. And the repeater will now have spread deviation when ADS firing and jumping. And some random like miscellaneous stuff. They fixed a bug preventing Steam users from sending friend requests to each other. Usernames will now update when the user swaps between the Origin client to the Steam client, and they fixed a bug preventing players from creating or joining clubs due to their EA account already being associated with another platform. And that's all for now. See you in the arena, legends. That's what the devs are saying. So overall, I'm very happy with all of the changes. I don't have anything bad to say. I know that some people are like very toxic about like the caustic changes. From what I saw, they really are unhappy with this because it's sort of like nerfing caustic. But that is something that's always going to happen in Apex Legends. That's one of the reasons why the game keeps being so interesting, because you have to try out new legends, and if they nerf someone, you can leave that legend for a while. You can go to another legend so you can play and figure out what suits you best. So I do believe that all of these changes are positive to the game, and are going to have generally a positive impact on everybody's plays. So yeah, I'm super happy with this. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please leave a like and subscribe. Don't forget to hit that bell too if you want to see more videos like this one. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye bye!